There are many who have issues with the characters of Jujutsu Kaisen because they are not doing anything. Although things are happening, they are not based on character motivations. The two replies I am showing here are indicative of how the fans of such shows treat the situation. It won't get any better than that, since it was good from the very beginning, is the fixed reply to anyone asking if the show ever gets good. Which is true, you either like it from the very beginning, or you constantly need validation from others for watching something you don't like. The other reply is, did you drop Naruto in 7 episodes as well? Implying the show wasn't good in 7 episodes, it got better later on. As if more episodes is the only fix to this issue, when it's not. That scene with Naruto being sad on the swing and constantly yelling he will be the best ninja in the world was enough to keep you going for hundreds of episodes. Itadori had no such thing, and his motivation to help people because his grandpa said so loses its steam right away because it was never much of a motivation, not one he had on his own, and not one that matters after its introduction. Typical to any story with a very lazily written plot, a character that joins a team no longer does something on his own. He moves with the team and his initial motivation stops being important. It's a common problem with any anime that has an organization in it. Whether it's a magic guild, a superhero academy, or an exorcist high school, when all the main characters are part of the same organization, they move as a group based on orders from the higher-ups instead of doing something on their own. This strips the urgency their objectives and motivations might have had. Jujutsu Kaisen is no exception, despite the characters starting off with something to strive towards. A few episodes later, it doesn't matter. They're just waiting for the next order to come instead of doing something towards achieving the initial motivation. Which is why, as the guy pointed out, the characters are not compelling. They are not working towards an objective. The orders have an objective, but it's not their objective, and it doesn't forward what they want to do. It forwards what the establishment wants to do, which in shonen is always on the side of the evil adults. Every time they follow orders, they serve the bad guys, and thus come off as collar workers than heroes you actually like following around in a shonen series. It's definitely not an easy task to give a freedom of movement in a show that is constantly increasing the number of its characters. From a point on, every character needs to be in a team or to follow orders, otherwise the plot will become too multi-layered and the writers will lose a track of what is going on. It's why the Z-Warriors and the Straw Hats begin by having their own personal objectives, and soon afterwards do nothing besides following around the protagonist instead of doing something on their own and thus remaining relevant in some fashion. At the same time, an easy way to make a character more compelling is to make him leave an organization or a team, because that way he becomes his own character and goes after his personal goals instead of following around the protagonist or waiting for orders. It's why characters like Usopp and Sasuke became so famous while they were not following orders, and why they became the same shit once they stopped and went back to following around the protagonist. Jujutsu Kaisen suffers from this exact issue. Nobody is doing something on his own. They are standing still, doing nothing, until the next event happens and they are ordered to participate. They are not compelling and they are a complete disappointment after the way they were introduced. It's the kind of shit that make people not give a damn about the characters after a while, and anticipating nothing more than power-ups, transformations, bunkais, and boobies. If the characters are a bunch of collar workers who are serving the corrupt establishment, then why give a damn about anything other than hair color swaps and bitch episodes? But look on the bright side. Jujutsu Kaisen has better animation than Attack on Titan, and since pretty colors is the only thing that people care about, there is nothing wrong with the show, and I am just nitpicking. Let's all praise Jujutsu Kaisen, a run-of-the-mill shonen, for having better animation than the anime that was hyped up to be the best series ever made because of pretty colors.